biggest level in this world. I can count myself truly lucky. I lived a charmed life. And now it would appear that I live a charmed death as well. Understand that the sentiment is not reciprocated. And you have every right to feel that way, knowing what you know. And since having come here to this place, I have realized perspective, the things that matter versus the things that really do not. But you see, I was a victim of my upbringing. I don't wish to lay the blame at the feet of anyone except for myself, of course. It's hard to ignore when you spend your life scrambling for table scraps, always smaller than the next man, always looked over, laughed at, bullied, shunned. It never sat well with me. It certainly added to my drive and ambition. As I've said, it's not an excuse. I don't believe there is any excuse for some of my behavior in life, chief among my transgressions. I was giving up butter. That was wrong. And if I had to do it again, I wouldn't. But there are other things, things that perhaps even with your new perspective that you might think I'd regret or do differently had I the chance. And most of them I would not. Liza was cruel to me. Yes, she was in love with me and I fostered that love with the false hope that I would reciprocate it one day, and yet you did the same to me. Why did you spare my life when Brandon was ready to strike me down? That's not mercy. In fact, that was one of the most unkind things that has happened to me. Not as unkind as Arya slitting my throat open, of course, but some betrayals are more subtle than others. I may not be the master of whispers, but I follow the players. I watch the game from a distance, and that gives me some perspective that perhaps some of the other players lack. Is it this perspective that allows me to play people off each other so effortlessly? It usually worked. Remember when I was born, I had nothing. The fingers. The laughable holdings. And I rose to become possibly the most important person in all of the Seven Kingdoms. Now, when I say important, I don't necessarily mean, obviously, I was never a king. I was a protector. still consider important possessions. The illusion of power. Those things were also part of my plan. And those things are trivia. They are motes of dust in the sun. Perhaps had I spent less time in those pursuits, I might have been watching my back a bit closer when I was at Winterfell, and I suppose it is fitting that I am sent here to one of the crypts of the place, the halls that I trod and betrayed so many times. I'm happy for that, if nothing else, then it allows me to see you. You most likely wish that I'd been condemned to the gods of wood, or Harrenhal. Who knows where else, but such is not the way of the gods. Perhaps there is a reason we were brought together. In fact, I'm quite surprised to see you here at all. You learn a lot when you die, and I learned that perhaps you were not quite dead, that perhaps you would walk upon Westeros once more. So imagine my surprise. Is still to come, but I can tell you that I was shocked. One with a heart like yours, made of stone, you deserve so much more. And I truly believe, had you chosen me, your life and the life of thousands upon thousands would have been much better. A cruel man, and I don't think I had unchecked ambition, but I did have ambition, and I still do. The knack now is how to use that ambition. Where can it be applied? Perhaps we will rise as walkers, you and I. That might be marvelous. And yet I do not think it's in the cards. I'm sure you remember this. It is the dagger. Assassin who tried to kill Bran. Well, that part was no lie. Whose dagger it was, of course, that was the lie. Small thing, a dagger. But then, if we're being honest with each other, a man's life is a small thing as well. We give so much importance to our lives. But in truth, they don't mean nearly as much as we wish they did, or as we imagine they do. Sparrow. Sansa. Pretty much. Almost as much as I loved you. And I never would have allowed her to come to harm. Now, Arya, on the other hand, she was trouble. It's funny, like I said, when you die, you get all sorts of new perspectives on your life. And strange insights into other lives. I dreamt I was the lord of a city. A strange, depraved city. With countless and countless numbers of people I have never imagined in my life. The city was called Baltimore. They said it, Palmer. Never heard of the city, no idea where it is. And yet I feel like in a parallel life. And perhaps that was my lot. I also feel slightly Scottish. I'm not sure what that even. Stark wants something done. They do it themselves. There's no hired assassins. They wield the blade. They lift the axe. There's a part of me that wants to say they pull the trigger. But I don't know what that means. Perhaps a crossbow. Fascinated by fire. It's no different in death. Of course, now there's no fear. As a child, I used to think that fire was a portal. How this world ends. Another thing that I thought was a bit ironic, one of the gods playing a trick on me, putting my own skull right next to me. So cruel. It's a bad joke. It's disgusting. I suppose it is something to see oneself reduced to the basest form. Perhaps there's something to be learned. But I still think it's cruel. Thank you. can't manage much more than that now. Thank you, daughter. Outsmarting people. Although, like I said, it can get tiresome. I miss the game a bit. There's no point in outsmarting people who are dead. Even you. There's no chance of me getting you. Smart. These old bones. Who is this? not proud of that, but there was a tyrant. She was unstable, your sister. You have to be able to admit that. I don't think this is her skull, though. But it needs to be. Some of the highlights of my life. I think you had no brother. You have to admit, that was a bit funny. Heather didn't think so. It broke my neck. Come on, your husband was a bit of a... goody-goody. Just that they have. at the cancer press, so they create a set of rules. So they won't transgress, even though they want to. And look, the actor who portrays me on the television show is Scottish, so I don't need to hear it. That's not how Littlefinger talks. I enjoy trying to do a Scottish accent. Anyways, only a film. The books are canon. The show's not. A bit too old, I think. it's about as hard as his was, though. Come on, we can laugh about these things now. We're dead. Come on. Loosen up a bit. I'm sure very soon someone will find it. Eventually, so whoever does find it, the door, the brothel. I hope they're good at exercise and restraint. See you around, Kat. Nice to catch up.